Let's bring in our panel now. Joining us, CNN political analyst Jackie Kucinich, who is the Washington bureau chief for the Daily Beast. CNN political commentator Mary Catherine Hamm, who's a senior writer at The Federalist. Also with me, David Ignatius, foreign affairs columnist at The Washington Post. And Jackie, first of all, beyond his position, is this draining the swamp to have somebody so affiliated with these energy industries to be in charge of energy policy?
I mean, I feel like there's two parts to draining the swamp, right? This is draining the regulations. this is about regulations. It's not about necessarily what you just said, having, you know, maybe some interests that you shouldn't have if you are the Secretary of Energy. That said, this is what Donald Trump said he was going to do. This is why some people, particularly in places like coal country, voted for him, because he said that he would roll back these regulations. So if this surprises anybody, I guess you weren't paying attention during the election, you know?
Absolutely not a surprise. And Mary Catherine, you know Mr. Ebell, right?
Yes, I know. I've worked with CEI in the past and done events with them. So like, well, I'm a libertarian radical on this regulation stuff, to put it nicely. I think most Americans, their relationship with the EPA comes more from fuel standards that might make their cars less efficient and make their fuel more expensive, or things like the coal regulations that make it tougher to get a job in the area. So their relationship with the EPA is not the same as a college-educated Ivy League kid who's panicky about climate change. It's just not the same. And I think the question was always, with climate change, not this adherence to whether it's true or not, but the question of what the government can actually do to change any of it. And I think certainly the Paris Accords and things like that, most Americans are like, yeah, I'm not seeing that work real well.
David, what do you think?
Well, I think first putting Ebell on the transition team is a symbolic action. It is an attempt to deliver for Trump's voters. I'm reminded of how Ronald Reagan appointed James Watt as Secretary of the Interior 30 years ago. Again, in a symbolic move, it was deeply upsetting to environmentalists back then. These regulations will be harder to undo than Trump and Ebell have implied. Mm-hmm. And also, there's so much momentum in the world now toward carbon reduction, sustainability. If you're a big global company trying to sell products, you want to be seen as pro-environment. You want to be seen as caring about the issue of climate change. And, you know, regulations one way or the other, I don't think are going to change that business reality that companies want to be seen as being involved in this.
In which case, I think that's a good reason not to panic about a guy who can probably get sort of incremental change done and streamlining done at the EPA while there is a cultural consensus that companies should be working on this.
Let's talk more broadly about the transition. I do not remember this much, at least, described chaos behind the scenes, Jackie, during the Obama transition or the Bush transition. Although we should point out, it was 3 weeks until President-elect Obama named a cabinet official.
Right.
So it's not as if not having named anybody a week out is symbolic of anything at all.
Well, right. There is a lot of palace intrigue here, though, right? And also, the other thing is, I feel like I'm at a balloon festival. There are so many trial balloons. There's a new name every day. Some make sense, some make absolutely no sense whatsoever, and, you know, we vet them all. But it does seem like we're being thrown off in some ways. And only, you know, only a couple people actually know who's actually being vetted, who is real. And that's hard to decipher here, because no one was expecting to be covering, let's be honest, to be covering a Trump transition.
I don't think the Trump transition was expecting
exactly
to be covering the Trump
transition. And which is hence the chaos.
So David, let me ask you, there's all this intrigue right now because Jared Kushner, the son-in-law of Donald Trump, has reportedly been purging not only former governor or former transition head Governor Chris Christie from the transition team, but also all these people who are fairly well respected in Washington who were affiliated with Christie. Kushner obviously hates Christie because Christie prosecuted his father back in 2005. None of this seems to me to have anything to do with how well Donald Trump can staff up an administration. Is this good advice that he's listening to?
Well, I think there is a kind of a night of the long knives quality as this Trump team sorts out who's going to be on top, who's going to have the president-elect's ear. Jared Kushner is a person who has a deep political personal history with Christie. I think there was general concern among the traditional foreign policy group in Washington when Mike Rogers, who was a key transition figure, former House Intelligence Committee chairman, a conservative Republican, but somebody who worked very hard to make his committee work, when he was ousted from a key position over the weekend, and others came into the center, I think the issue really is, are they going to have qualified, experienced people directing these most sensitive activities of the U.S. government, or people who are less knowledgeable, less trustworthy?
All right, David Ignatius, Mary Catherine Hamm, Jackie Kucinich, thank you, one and all.